Hey guys, it's Chris. From ships that were partially sunk for no reason, to sightings that truly cannot be explained. Join me as I reveal 8 of the most mysterious incidents to happen on ships and submarines. Number 8, USS Cyclops. For anyone who has sailed the seas, the thing you never want to hear is that there is a boat in distress, meaning that they're sinking or in danger of sinking. But just as bad is hearing that a boat is missing, and they don't know where it is. But this is what happened in 1918, when in March of that year, a massive Navy ship vanished. This was the USS Cyclops, and at the time, it was the biggest ship in the Navy. It was 550 feet long and had over 1,000 crew members. Lest you think this was a new vessel that had a flaw, it had been sailing for 8 years without a hitch. She had been to multiple oceans, helped out in many kinds of missions, and at the time, in 1918, was a key supply and delivery vessel for the United States during World War I. Her final mission before disappearing was taking supplies of metal and ore from South America to Baltimore, Maryland. And she left Brazil fine, made it to Barbados, and gave the fair weather all well signal before departing the country. The final leg of the trip should have taken 9 days, but the Cyclops never made it home. This remains one of the biggest mysteries at sea to this day. Number 7. U-28 Crocodile. During World War I, there was a British steamer known as the Iberian. It was going through waters next to Ireland when it came under attack by a German submarine known as U-28. A battle commenced, and the German submarine would win out in the end. However, when the captain of the submarine, Baron von Forstner, went to the periscope to watch the Iberian sink, he got the chance to see something he couldn't explain. For soon after the Iberian fully sank, there was an explosion. It was likely the Iberian's internals giving out and causing the blast. But whatever caused it, Forstner claimed that he saw a massive sea crocodile thrown into the air. And he was not joking or trying to pull the leg of his crew in order to further lighten the mood after their victory. In fact, he wrote an article about it in a German newspaper in 1933 and said the following. The animal was about 20 meters long and crocodile-like in shape, with pairs of strong front and hind legs adapted for swimming, and a long head that tapered towards the nose. He claimed to have seen it for 10 to 15 seconds at a distance of about 150 to 100 meters in bright sunlight. Usually, accounts like this would go under the idea of stress or mirage or something of the like, but this incident has things that certain monster accounts don't have, not the least of which was that the captain was very specific about what he saw. He gave measurements, noted that it was bright outside, gave key details about the monster's shape and more. Not to mention, he had just gotten glory in a battle, so there's no point in talking about a monster unless it's really there. There's more to this incident, though, as 6 other crew members claim to have seen the creature, and certain credited scientists believe he honestly did see it. And one zoologist, Bernardo Velmons, felt the description matched up with a prehistoric giant crocodile that could possibly still be living today, called the Thalatosicchia. Recent discoveries in the waters of the planet have proven that there are indeed ancient creatures still around from prehistoric days. So could the captain truly have seen an ancient crocodile? Number 6. Mary Celeste. The Mary Celeste was a ship from 1872 that was abandoned in the Atlantic Ocean a month after setting sail for a journey to Italy. This particular ship was a merchant ship, so it being abandoned like that would be a bit odd in its own right. But that was only the beginning of the mystery around this ship. So that raises the question, why was it abandoned? Was it because it was raided, and that raid led to the deaths of crew and sinking of the ship? No, that's not what happened. It did partially sink, yes, but all its cargo was intact and untouched. Adding to the mystery, there was no clue as to where the crew went outside of a lifeboat missing, and they were never found, and thus couldn't tell their story. Just as odd, there was apparently 6 months' worth of provisions on board, so there's no way it was starvation or lack of supplies that caused the crew to flee. So again, why was the ship abandoned? And no one knows. It's a true maritime mystery, one that hasn't been solved and likely never will be. There are many guesses, of course, including some beyond the scope of what's logical. But the fact remains, the ship was there and the crew wasn't. So what could have caused them to abandon it if they were in no danger of dying while on it for some time? Number 5. USS Scorpion. The year was 1968. The USS Scorpion was a submarine that had nuclear capabilities, and the US was in the middle of the Cold War, and thus had to be on alert for anything that could go wrong. Yet one day, while in the Atlantic Ocean, it disappeared, vanished without a trace. It wasn't until later that the pieces of the submarine were found lost on the ocean floor. Many have wondered what happened to it and its nuclear arsenal. This had led to many theories, both probable and not so probable, about what happened. What's more, many people have reopened the investigation about the disappearance of the submarine and tried to find the rest of the wreckage so the answers could potentially be found. Yet no search has wielded anything but speculation. This even happened as recently as 2012. The most popular theory is that there was a torpedo failure of some kind, and it caused the ship to rupture and take the lives of the 99 crew members. But until the full wreckage is found, we'll never know. Number 4. The Baltic Sea Mystery. Russia is not the most popular country in the world right now. And in 2014, they were drawing the ire of Sweden for many reasons, not the least of which was that they were constantly and emphatically invading their sovereign space in various ways, such as when they had two jets fly over the country, or when they abducted one of their government officials and literally dragged them back to Moscow for reasons only known to them. In that same year, the people of Sweden reported seeing something in the Baltic Sea, a submarine, one that was clearly Russian in make and model. While one report is hardly conclusive in any way, multiple people reported seeing it because it was on the surface and just idling there, not something a submarine is known to do outside of docking. When reports reached the government of this, they launched a massive initiative to find the ship, and a week later, no trace of the submarine was found. And that doesn't technically mean it wasn't there. It just might have gotten out before being spotted. But why was it there at all? No one knows. Number 3. Gulf of Mexico Shipwreck. The idea of a cursed ship is not new in this world, but when it comes to the shipwreck that lies in the Gulf of Mexico, it's one that many people truly believe to be cursed thanks to lots of evidence backing it up. The ship itself was from the 1800s. It was a 65-foot wooden sailing ship, and it got discovered quite by accident, as oil company ExxonMobil was trying to lay down a pipeline when they discovered the ship. Naturally curious, they tried to search it but couldn't get close, not because of ocean waters or animals or anything like that, but because every time they tried, something would go wrong with their equipment. Not long after, the US Navy came to help with the shipwreck, and they too experienced the curse when the sub they sent tried to deploy its rover, and it almost self-destructed. And though it did reach the ship, the arms of the rover were too small to do anything. Since then, many more ships and vessels have tried to find out information about the boat, but each time the curse strikes back at them hard. Though some success has been had, the number of odd instances in regard to machine failure helps cement this curse as real in many minds. Number 2. Cargo ship under the World Trade Center. After the tragedy that was 9/11, the people of the United States decided to rebuild the site of the former Twin Towers into what we know now as One World Trade Center. Yet to do so, they had to dig down deep into the earth to help secure the foundation of the new building. As they reached about 20 feet down, they found something very odd. A cargo ship, one that, based on its construction and materials, was pretty old, by about a few centuries. So how did a cargo ship get under the ground of the original World Trade Center? And where did it come from? In 2014, scientists examined the wood that made up the ship and determined that it came from Philadelphia in 1773. As for how it got underground, it made its final resting place in Lower Manhattan. And when the New York Harbor shoreline crept closer and closer to it, the ship slowly got buried by trash and landfill, until finally, at around 1818, the ship was buried from sight, and it was only found after the events of 9/11. While this does explain much of the mystery, many are still amazed that this ship remained undetected for centuries, and that the former World Trade Center was built on top of it with nobody noticing. Number 1. SS Edmund Fitzgerald. There have been many ships over the years that have gone down in various places due to storms, but the SS Edmund Fitzgerald remains one of the biggest mysteries of this lot because it didn't go down in the ocean. It went down in Lake Superior in the United States. Lake Superior is known to act like a sea, which means that it gets its own storms from time to time. This included November 1975, when she and another ship, the Arthur M. Anderson, set off from Detroit and into the storm towards their destinations. But the storm raged so much they had to alter their course in order to ensure they didn't get turned over by the then massive waves. The captain of the SS Edmund Fitzgerald made it known over the radio what they were gonna do, but not long after it, the ship vanished. The Arthur M. Anderson made it to its new destination, but upon hearing what happened, went back to find the other ship, and all the captain found was a set of tattered lifeboats and a life jacket. Eventually, the wreck of the SS Edmund Fitzgerald was found. It was battered and broken in many places, but weirdly, there wasn't a single body on board. leading many to wonder what really happened on that vessel, and where the crew went if they didn't go down with the ship. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these mysteries of various ships and submarines? Which one did you find the most intriguing? What about the most mysterious? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to World List, and I'll see you next time.